Geez, that's some good acting, mate. We'll have to pay you some more money. Well, so what do you got in there?
Crabs and some other stuff.
Yeah.
Sweet.
We got a big crab in there.
We're going to use it for bait, are we, to catch some bigger fish? How many crabs do you reckon you've got?
About four.
What is that? Oh, it's one of those funny things. Alright, we've got to where the little bits of seaweed are. Usually these bits of seaweed are connected to a cockle, so I think we've come far enough. They're not thick and fast, but we should be able to get enough for feed here anyway.
It's so deep.
It's deep, is it? Oh, that's a nice cockle. Awesome. Yep, let's get a few more, eh, so we can have a bit of a feed. Oh, that's a big one. Any more? Oh, throw that little one away. Give that big one a wash off. We'll put that in. We've got enough cockles for a feed, so we're going to quit while we're ahead, leave some for the next fellas that come down and get them. Might go light a fire and boil some up, have lunch, I think. What do you got, Charlie?
There's a crab inside.
Oh, it's a bunch of oysters. Hold it up, just look at it. Oh, that's pretty cool, isn't it?
And there's a crab inside.
Is it? Where? Oh, right inside that oyster. Sweet. Hey! Alistair scored himself an anchor on a chain. Look at that. Look at that, Charlie.
Anchor.
The ocean giveth and the ocean taketh away, but this time it's giveneth. Is it worth salvaging, Charlie? What do you reckon?
Yeah.
Yeah, are you sure? The old galve, oh, there's still a bit of galve under there. I don't know, I think Alistair's right. I think it's done its dash. Should we leave it there for someone else to find? You got a lighter, mate?
I'm gonna get one.
All right. So we're going to go, well, Charlie's hopefully going to fire a lighter, otherwise I'm going to have to rub two sticks together, just magic fire up like I do on TV, and light a little fire and cook the cockles up, have them on bread with a bit of butter. Luckily we've got some bread in there, and then we're going to go drive to Nelson to the big smoke. Boys, come down, pull me out in the Legacy. Alistair come down to help Toby in his truck, and Reese Piggott came down to direct. He's gone home now. How are we looking in there? Ooh, yeah. You reckon there? Oh, almost ready. You put it on. We'll put it on. Seal it down just for a little bit longer. A couple more seconds. But this is Alistair's first crack at a cockle. He's from down central Otago. Not many cockles down them ways, down Cromwell. I think they got power in the canals, but no cockles. Man, come have a go. Do you like mussels?
Grab one from in here.
Don't know if you'll eat one.
Oh, really?
It's a bit fussy sometimes.
I'll eat yours for you, mate. What do you reckon, Charlie? Good?
What do you do?
Yeah, have one straight out of the shower, mate. Let's see your reaction.
Like
yep, just rip it out.
You eat the whole lot, eh?
Yeah, mate. Guts and all.
Yep.
Hooked?
Good. Pretty good, actually.
He'll be down there every night after work. I told him, I said, mate, once you have one, you'll be down there every time you can get time off bloody getting cockles. Look at that, why not? There's millions of them out there, and it's a really good source of omega-3 right at your doorstep. And this is the best way to eat them. Bit of butter, bit of white bread. Well, we don't actually have white bread. We've got healthy bread. Well, it's best to have white bread. Hey, you've got to make out with the healthy stuff with the unhealthy white bread. Fresh white bread, it's got to be fresh, can't be stale, and heaps of butter.
Fold
her in half.
Might put another
slice on top. Good. All right, that's our feed done. Lunchtime, off to Nelson. See you later. Nice to meet you. To meet you, nice. Cheers, Alistair.
No worries, cheers.
Cheers, Charlie.
You know Alistair's.
That's yours.
No, that's yours.
Oh, that's yours. Awesome, thank you. See you later. Hey, what do you reckon, Charlie? It's a pretty good boat, this one, isn't it? And Jason's testing a top secret DNA down there. Man, this thing's a bloody cruise ship, check it out. Toilet in there. Shower, even. Ah, yes. Wonder what the poor people are doing today. Driving the rich person's boat.
Yep. Gypsies in the palace, mate.
What can you see?
Fish and chips.
That's right, you heard it here first. Fish and chips. It is Sunday after, well, Friday's actually the traditional Kiwi Bushman fish and chip night. We usually make our own, but seeing as we didn't catch any fish today because we got stuck in the old D-Max, it just, and then the other trucks got stuck trying to get us out, and then the tractor came and pulled us all out. We're buying fish and chips. We did have cockles though that we caught ourselves, and they were delicious.
Crank it, there we go. Yep, yep. We'll hold it open for these people here.
No,
you're first. No, after you.
Are you sure?
Yeah, definitely.
Cool, thank you.
You're welcome.
Sir, we're hungry. Cook faster. But that's what we could have caught. We could have caught some gurnard today, but we didn't. We could have caught some snapper today, but we didn't. We could have caught some blue cod today. You almost caught a flounder, didn't you?
Yeah,
that's right.
It was tidy.
And the fish of the day is blue warahau.
Hey, Dad, look, Dad.
What have you got?
Look.
Oh yeah, look at that. Is that a real fossil? There you are, sir. Have a good evening. Are you practicing your karate skills, are you? I'll kung fu your ass one of these days. I will.
I'll kung fu your ass because you'll be
Look at that. I gave it the old West Coast cut and polish today. She's looking nice. Nice and polished, that's how we like it, eh, Charlie? Bit of character on there. Mate, are they hot?
They're warm.
Right, let's get them around to Jace's, eh?
Yep. I'll leave them on.
Rangitoto Kiti Tonga, or Durville Island, sits at the northernmost tip of New Zealand's Southern Island. To the north of Durville Island is Stephens Island, separating these two islands, Stephens Passage. Teeming with fish.
Wow, she's an absolute cracking day in Nelson. Absolute pearler in the ocean. It's meant to be fairly good conditions, getting better tonight and then really good tomorrow morning. So what we're going to do, we're going to call on and see the fellas at Big Blue. This fella started his truck up just as I started talking. So we're going to jump in on Jason's DNA boat. Yes, Jason, the head honcho from DNA, is coming along for the ride, taking his 570 XT hardtop for a spin. Yesterday, me and Charlie actually took it for a spin, and Charlie caught a couple of gurnard and I caught some dogfish.
Sweet, another gurnard. Mate, you're catching
caught
all the fish.
Me.
Caught by who?
Me. You're catching no fish and I'm catching, I already caught two.
Finally caught a fish, and it's a spiny dog.
Big Blue.
Big Blue, that's right. Look at all this fishing gear. See you later, Paul.
Later. Have a good trip.
Yeah. Paul was just giving me shit for having the life that, the life of Riley. It's pretty good life, thanks to you guys. So here we are, outside Big Blue, in the DNA 570 XT hardtop. And look who's coming along. Hey, we got little princess there and big princess over here. Where are you? She's poke your head up there. Oh, she's shy. Here we go. And the lovely Melissa as well. There you go. She's the boss. And the where's the lackey? He's not in here.
What pump's there?
Oh, there he is. Hey.
Hey, mate. Pump. Has that got a pump number?
Another
head. Oh, for kids. Pump, good shit. You've got a couple already, eh?
Yeah, I have. No, someone scratched it off.
Pump number three.
That's eight. That one might be seven. It's all very confusing. Because it must be seven, bro. That's six. Hey, mate.
Hey, George. How are you?
Good.
What's happening? Ready to go again?
Ready to go again. We're going fishing. Mark showed us the secret gurnet spot yesterday and we caught two gurnet. I think it was the secret dogfish spot. I didn't catch any gurnet actually, I just got dogfish.
It's Jace's spot.
Oh, Jace's spot.
He told me not to give you all the good spots.
I did actually follow the little fish mark on the boat there and it took me straight to the dogfish. Mark's got some rods and reels for me. He's seen the shit rods and reels I've been using and said he'd give me some more. Isn't that awesome? Don't know what the price is going to be. We'll take it out of my hide later on, I guess. But look at all the crap in this store. If you need any fishing gear, come here. Shimano's.
Apparently jig masters don't come in pink rods.
Ah, jig masters don't come in pink.
There
we go.
They do, there is one in pink.
But it was too small, wasn't it?
Yeah. Gulp.
Jason's too fussy.
Yeah. He is.
Oh, hunting, here we go. Hunting and fishing and wetsuits. I didn't realise there was an upstairs here.
And here.
Look at that, yep, all the gears.
I already knew there was wetsuits up here.
Oh, did you? Wow. Jasmine already knew that.
Looks pretty calm. Let's.
A bit rough.
I know, I've seen the pictures. It's a whole 2 to 3 knots, isn't it?
All of that.
There you go, Swell Map don't know what they're talking about because they gave it a rating of 1, but some joker that you know cruised out there and said it was flat as a pancake.
Yeah, I was just talking to him, he's there right now.
Mm. Bloody Swell Map, it's put me off. Next time it says it's 1 on the west coast, I'm just going to ignore him and go out anyway.
Not an our boat.
Oh. Yeah, 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 I am.
It's a DNA in here.
Yeah, handles the jandle. Right, I'm rolling. What do you got to tell me about this?
So we've got a cover to keep it protected, Shimano cover. Italica 12. You've got 80-pound coloured braid on it. You've got a 120-pound leader. And I've even done your PR knot for you, mate. I've
good
put
on
the leader
you.
On.
Sweet.
That's usually extra. And you've got the Anarchy, top of line Shimano, 200-400 gram jig rod. This is the Monster 30-kilo Kingy Basher rod for you, mate.
That's what my bloody warehouse rod said. It said good for catching kingfish, snapper, mullet, kawai, and all the rest of it. And I only had it for about 2 weeks, and then the drag didn't work anymore.
This is Shimano, mate. It's quality. 18-kilo drag. Look at it.
Oh, it's got that drag lever on it too, eh? So
yeah,
you just whack.
Jace will help you set your drag. But, look at that, mate, eh?
Crank it up.
Maximum.
This fella knows what he's talking about. A whole bunch of people out fishing for the snapper, well, the Riwaka Hunting Club, didn't catch. Oh, the biggest snapper was, I don't know, 40 centimetres long, and Mark sent me a whole bunch of photos that... Mark sent me a whole bunch of photos of snapper he caught in the day, and check these fish out, they're massive. Tackle Care 101 with Big Blue.
Oh, don't ask me, I don't look after them.
I was just going to ask Mark how to look after your reels, because I get home and just hose them down with fresh water, but he said don't ask him. Who should I ask? We'll put Mario on the spot, eh?
Yeah, put Mario on.
Mario, what's the best way to look after our reels, mate?
Yep.
When we get in.
Keep the cover on it when you're driving along.
Yep.
Just take the cover off when you go to use it. Once you used it, finish using it, give it a hose down, light hose down, keep the drag on. That keeps the water from going into the drag. And then just lie it down this way around. You'll find there's a couple of drain holes in the top here.
To store it.
Or just after you've washed it, okay. So any water that's gone in will just drain out those holes.
And is that pretty standard with all rod and reel sets, or is that
overhead
Shimano specific?
Overheads, they will have, if I can see it here, a couple of drain holes in the top. That little hole there should be one on both sides. So once you've given it a hose down, you want it that way around, so the water will drain out.
And with your spin reels, just tighten up the drag when you wash them.
Good as gold. That's good to know. There you go. So I didn't know that. I just get home and I chuck my reels up against the garage and hose the shit out of them. Apparently, just give them a light wash down. And Vaseline. When I was a kid, we used to take into bits and put Vaseline in them. But these days, it's pretty complicated inside, eh?
Yeah.
You just use them until they break.
Just a light spray of either tackle guard or Inox spray over it and give it a wipe down. And that gives it a bit of a protective layer. Helps keep the water out as well.
Mark's going to show us how to tie a PR knot. He's actually going to show Jason how to tie a PR knot.
Hey.
Oh, well. Because I'm not sure if you remember from the last episode, but Jason's PR knot came undone. Come on, Jace. Oh, here's our mate, old Molly Mork, coming for a look.
Oh, no. Jason, would you like 20 pounds, sir, or 30 pounds?
Yeah, so I just asked Mark why he's putting the nylon on, the monofilament on, before the braid, and it's because if you put the braid straight on the metal spool, it spins, it won't grip. You can do it, but you've got to wrap a couple of wraps of electrical tape around first. Is that right?
Yeah,
there you go. But just to be sure, probably better to put the monofilament on and then put the braid on top of that.
PR knot, feed it through. You got the little O-rings there to hold it in. So you squeeze it in there, pull that up snug, and then you want to do it around there about 20 turns probably, give or take. 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 19, 20. There's lots of ways of doing this. This is my way anyway. This wants to be reasonably snug. Right, so then you get your mono and the braid, wind that round a couple of grips so it's nice and snug, then spin that around like so, wind that up and get a couple of grips there, then it sort of sits that way. Then you want to wind it back down a couple of loops around the line there. I don't know if you can see that.
Yep, so the same direction. Go back the other way, eh?
Then you go back over and try and just get a little loop over and then spin it back the other way, and it should pack in nice and tight. A lot of people do it like a 2-inch one. I think it's too big. It seems, you know, because we get a lot of barracuda down here, it's quite a big target, you know. So an inch long is more than enough. Then you can take that off the bobbin, snip it off, and then you could do a half hitch. Just to lock it off there. And then combining them both, you want to do a half hitch like so. Now the secret is to have a bit of tension there. Jace, I'm going to need your assistance here please, sir. It's getting serious. Then we just want to wrap around there so that it packs in nice and tight. Get that, trim the tag end off, and Josh, behind you there's a cigarette lighter, mate. Burn a bit of the tag end there. So then you just want a half hitch up to that mushroom you just did with the lighter and alternate it.
This is the finicky bit, isn't it? And see how he's pinching the line there? He can help guide the knot to get it where he wants to go.
Doesn't matter too much if you alternate or not. It's
as long as you get those knots in there, eh?
As long as you keep packing it in, and the main thing is the drag. Ted, tension is the secret to the whole ordeal. Then once you're up to that, go straight over it. You can alternate over the top. You only have to do about 4 or 5 turns. And then what you can do is do like a finishing knot. So you come up around. If you can manage to do it with a... You pull it up tight. Then what you do is feed that around, kind of like you're going around to... See how it snugs it all in there? Pull that tight. You can chop the tag end off right up close. There you go. Smooth. To finish that, you put a bit of wax or anything on top of that, and that'll just smooth it off. And that's a PR knot. Looks good.
Looks better than mine.
Sweet.
Butters. All good. Cheers, boys.
Thanks, Josh.
Nice one.
Thanks, mate. Good luck.
You better get out there. Get out there before it gets dark, because it's already mid-afternoon. We've got a bit of a drive to launch a boat and then a bit of a steam out to get to our fishing grounds. Really looking forward to putting this reel for its paces. Stoked. Finally, some good gear. Actually, the last reel I bought from here was pretty good too. It was kind of a medium range one, but this is top of the line, so I'm pretty happy to finally have some good equipment.
Dad?
Yeah?
Can I please have that and you can have that?
Hell no. That was it. That was the launching of the boat, because we're in a hurry to get out and go fishing. The bloody sun's going down. Today we are powered by Honda. There it is. Powered by the Honda, and we're floating in a DNA boat. And we catch our fish on Shimano, Okuma, Warehouse rods, Blimmin', what else have we got up there?
Jigmaster.
Kaius, Jigmaster 2001, Ocean Blimmin' Offshore Series.
Here's my own rod.
Here's Charlie's own rod, yep, there we go. You stole it off me already.
Yeah.
Oh, is it?
Yeah, oh. I swapped you from my rod for
you. Oh, he swapped the Okuma for the Shimano. Don't know if it's a good trade yet, we'll find out. All right, I'm rolling. Missy?
No pressure.
Yeah, that'll do, crank it. All right, Chops are trying to escape. Get up there, Chops. We've caught one barracuda so far, had about four or five drops. Only seen one kingy mark on the sounder. Just one. Not looking good. Come on, kingfish, blooming neck.
The sun's out.
Where's the moon?
Oh,
there it is up there. Any Pokemons out there, bro? I
haven't seen any Pokemons today. There might be one off, I don't even know how it works.
One on the rock, eh? Hey? I wonder if you can drop them.
I'm going to make a joke about it, but I don't know how it works.
It's cool to drop it on the rock.
You have to hack into the Pokemon thing.
What?
You have to hack into the Pokemon thing.
Oh, do you? Oh, the current is just ripping through here at the moment. Ripping through, and we can't seem to get onto any kings.
You see some sign on there, did you?
Oh, might be barracuda sign.
Hey, Dad, can I let your line out? My line out.
Barracuda are a delicacy. Maybe we'll eat one of those tonight for tea. Delicacy in South America. I get comments from people over there going, why are you throwing them out? Why do you throw the cuda away? They're delicious. I don't think they are.
Maybe call it worm?
Yeah, maybe I'll go on the worm diet. Good way to lose weight. No, the cuda worms eat people. People fat, maybe. Oh, we need the hook up now. It's perfect. The sun's just perfect.
Hope the camera's rolling.
Yeah! No kingfishing on the end.
Not yet.
We just radioed some other fishermen up around the top of Durville there, and they said there wasn't anything happening over there. It had gone really quiet in the last hour, so we decided to stay here and fish on the incoming tide. Although this particular spot is better on the outgoing tide. We've seen a bit of sign on the sounder, probably two kingfish marks, but that's it. There's not a heck of a lot. The sun's just about to drop below the horizon. Just picked up some pretty good cod sign on the sounder. Looks like we're gonna give the kids a bit of a crack. Seeing as the adults can't produce, maybe it's time for the kids to pull in some dinner. I'm just rigging up my line here. Jason doesn't have any hooks. He's got sinkers and rigs and slow jigs and jigs and Lucano jigs and Shimano bottom ships. And
I got rusty hooks.
Rusty old hooks. Mate.
How's it going, Jade? Still coming up?
I think Jasmine needs to use that reel,
mate. Look at the state of those. Look, can't see anything. Why the eye just dropped them on the floor. Is it a snapper?
Yeah.
A little baby one. Oh, baby blue cod. Oh, it's still sharp. Must be black magic. Rusty and sharp. Is anyone keeping an eye on the rocks as we're drifting around?
Sort of.
It's a good thing we're not pissheads, eh? I don't know how long
we'd already be on top of the
rock. Yeah. Hey! Seem to run aground. Winch it in, mate. Don't drop that bloody rod in.
Oh,
Sounds like a big angry fish.
I'm about to keep fish on me.
Pull him in, Charlie. Nice.
Two keepers.
Yeah, grab it.
I got the biggest key. I got the biggest blue card. Two biggest blue cards.
Well done.
I'm the champion.
Caught on a rusty black magic size 4 big hook and a rusty black magic size 7 circle beak hook thing.
Wow, look at that.
Well, we caught a couple of cod. It's now gone dark and we've been searching for the elusive snapper for about 15 minutes now. Jason's cruising around looking at the Simrap trying to find them, but they've snapped their way off the greener pastures. We don't have far to go to our campsite. It's just in Port Hardy, around the corner there. You see it, Charlie?
See what?
A campsite. How about you, Jazz? Any campsite out there? No. I'm going in for a look. This looks like we're here, so I've got my short shorts on, my man dress. I'm going to go check it out. There's a lot of piper out there. We might go see if we can catch some later on. But I'm pretty sure this is it. Looks like a pretty good campsite anyway. Wading short. Durville Island Scenic Reserve. This is us. I think we've made it. How you going, guys? You got lots of firewood?
Yes, it's up there.
Is there a campsite up there? Looks good, eh? I can't feel my feet anymore.
It's too cold.
Too cold, that's right.
Can you do the ABCs backwards?
Doesn't help.
Right, Charlie, now that these guys have been setting up their tents for 15 minutes, let's go set ours up. Let her rip, mate. Here we go. Chuck a sleeping bag in there and we're ready to go. And that, folks, is one reason for getting a swag, because it's so quick and easy. Ye old hard antler swag. Managed to sneak up on some chops in Jason's freezer. Jason's going for a bit of a wade. I reckon he's going for a swim. He reckons he's going for a wade. You alright there, Captain? Good zoom on this camera. Did you bring the knife in, Jace? Oh, he forgot the fish as well. He's going to have to swim back out and get it. Don't forget the knife, Jace. I should probably tie this rope up like he asked me to, because it's slowly getting dragged into the ocean. Nice, cup of Milo for the boys.
Want any honey?
Oh, it looks good now. Are you going to have a chop too, Jazz?
You going to sleep there, bro?
Nope.
G'day, Charlie. Hey, Jade.
How's it?
It's good. Look at that cheeky fella. I went for a walk out this morning to get the drone off the boat. Jason was giving me stick for not bringing it in close to the shore, but I think that was well worth it. Pretty nice to start the day with a cold wash. I think it's because you get the oxygen flying. It's like the Wim Hof breathing methods. Oh, there's our blooming. Is that our boy right out there, mate? It's miles out. There's another boy around there too. Maybe that's a log. That might be our other boy around the corner. There must be another campsite over there.
Are we stuck on the bottom?
We certainly are stuck on the bottom. There we go. That's moving. Jesus. I think we're going to have to unload the boat again and push it out deeper.
Everyone stand at the front. Right at the front.
Right at the front. Holy crap. We're away.
lucky. If we had left it another 15 minutes, we'd still be stuck there until the tide come in tonight. We'd be here all day catching spotties off the rocks. Man, what an excellent campsite though. We did hear there was a mooring here. Well, did you see one on the rocks over there?
Sorry,
oh, way over there around the corner. I wonder if there's another campsite around there. It's a long way to swim. Nice. Cheer. Cheer.